I'm Katherine Swanson, ICMSF member since 2001 and food safety consultant. This presentation is about microbiological testing for validation and verification in food processing. In this presentation, you will learn the difference between verification and validation and why both are important for an effective food safety management program. The term microbiological testing brings a variety of images to mind depending upon the audience and the individual. For example, some people think about vast quantities of data that can be analyzed for risk assessment. Others think of using microbiological testing in a detective game to identify an unknown microorganism or a causative agent in a foodborne illness outbreak or spoilage situation. Still others think of microbiological testing as an implied guarantee that a specific lot of food is absolutely safe without recognizing that uncertainty exists. And others, microbiological testing is a practical quality management tool that provides information to indicate whether a process is performing as expected. Different types of testing can be applied for all of these purposes. However, this presentation focuses on the last two elements, that is, testing for process control and product acceptance. For effective food safety management, it is important to consider both validation and verification. Let's start with validation first. According to the Codex Alimentarius Commission, the term validation means obtaining evidence that a control measure or combination of control measures, if properly implemented, is capable of controlling the hazard to a specified outcome. In other words, proper validation answers the question, does the control actually work? To determine this, scientists and engineers conduct studies, such as cooking to a certain temperature and for a certain time, to obtain evidence a process or treatment will reliably destroy specific pathogens of concern. As the temperature of a product increases with time, the initially happy bacteria become stressed and are ultimately inactivated to a specified outcome in a properly validated process. The specific treatment varies depending upon the process, the food, and a number of other factors. Because of this, proper validation is essential to determine critical factors that ensure a food safety plan can actually control the identified hazard. Without proper validation, the effectiveness of the process to control food safety risk isn't known. Regulatory guidance or industry standards frequently provide validated process parameters for many products. For example, time and temperature requirements for pasteurized milk are typically specified by governments. When such guidance is not available, proper validation is important to avoid taking bad road and having a food safety incident because the designed process is not effective at actually controlling the hazard. There is an obvious link between verification and validation. Codex Alimentarius guidelines define verification as the application of methods, procedures, tests, and other evaluations in addition to monitoring to determine whether a control measure is or has been operating as intended. While the process validation study provides evidence that the process will control an identified hazard, it usually assumes that good hygienic practices are implemented, equipment is capable of delivering the process, and employees are trained to perform their assigned task properly. Verification is needed to provide evidence that these conditions are met. Many verification procedures do not involve microbiological sampling and testing. However, it is important to recognize that such testing may be useful for some products. This may include targeted sampling and testing of ingredients, in-process materials, environmental samples, and finished products. Recommended microbiological tests can vary considerably for different food products. There is no specific set of tests that are useful for all food products. However, ICMSF's Microorganisms in Food 8, Use of Data for Assessing Process Control and Product Acceptance, which is published by Springer, identifies microbiological testing for 19 different food product categories. These tests may be performed on samples from primary production, ingredients, in-process samples, environmental monitoring, shelf life tests, and end products. Introductory chapters also address general principles related to microbiological testing of food, including validation of control measures, verification of process and environmental control, corrective action to reestablish control, and microbiological testing in customer-supplier relationships. You can find information on this book on the publisher's website, and translations of Book 8 are also available in Spanish, Portuguese, Chinese, and Japanese. In 2018, the second edition of Microorganisms in Food 7 is anticipated, and Book 7 provides more information on validation and verification. In conclusion, recommended microbiological tests can vary considerably for different food products. Despite limitations related to the sensitivity and time to result, microbiological testing can play an important role in effective food safety management. For many products, validation testing is done to determine the specific parameters that, when properly controlled, will effectively control the microbial hazard of concern. Verification testing is also recommended for many food products to demonstrate that controls are being implemented as intended. Please visit the ICMSF website at www.icmsf.org for more information on ICMSF books and tools.